the streets of Los Angeles today. Chris Blatchford is here with the story. Chris?
Now, remember as you watch this, this crime was committed by teenagers, is senseless, and by any reasonable standard, unprovoked. But it is also an all-too-familiar scene among segments of today's youth. We warn you, some of what you will see is quite graphic.
Is Kicker, and he walks into this El Monte pool hall with a swagger. He feels good here. It is a hangout for his gang, the Asian Boys, and he has a .45 caliber pistol tucked under his checkered shirt. His real name is Lay Mek, an 18-year-old Cambodian refugee with a history of weapons and violence. What he doesn't know as he stands here talking to some girlfriends is it will be his last night alive. A short time later, about 20 members of a rival gang called Wa Ching come through the door at the upper left of your TV screen. Among them, Kicker's alleged executioner. Police identify him as 18-year-old Chu Luang Yang, an Upland High School dropout who refers to himself as China Dog. You see him here wearing the white T-shirt. And according to police reports obtained by Fox News, the Wa Ching gangsters were upset because the Asian boys were mad-dogging them, staring at them. Witnesses say at one point there is an argument between Kicker, seen here on the left, and rival Wa Ching gang member Chris Ha. Ha says he and his friends started leaving after Kicker flashed the .45 kept at his belt. At this point, police records indicate one of the Wa Ching gangsters said, "Let's go. Don't worry about it. I'll take care of it. I'll put a bullet in his head for you." More words were exchanged while Wa Ching backed out, one pointing at Kicker in apparent anger. Kicker paces, seems to say something in return, and rubs his hands together. A short time later, Kicker, police say still working his mouth, passes in front of several Wa Ching gangsters who have not yet left. When he turns his back, China Dog grabs him and throws him to the floor. As they drag him toward the door, a half dozen Asian boys, some with pool cues, try to stop the Wa Ching attack. There is no audio on the surveillance tape, but witnesses say the room was filled with screaming and yelling. An Asian boy nicknamed Mousy even grabs a .32 caliber pistol off a nearby pool table, but it jams when he comes back and tries to fire at rival Wa Ching. Investigators believe Kicker's gun was taken from him during this struggle. About the same time, the first gunman pops through the door and fires wildly into the crowded pool hall. This teenager, who does not want to be identified, is one of five survivors hit by gunfire.
The bullet went from my head, but I could hear the wind, and then down there, I feel my leg get shot.
Then, as Wa Ching coolly dragged Kicker outside, a second gunman steps through the door and starts firing. Police say it is China Dog Yang. Kicker reappears with a body tackle, but can't hold on. Gets five shots in his body while scrambling for cover, then two fatal slugs in the head at close range.
It was really scary. I thought, like, they won't stop, you know. I was like, what am I doing here, you know? I'm not one of them, and I got shot, you know?
Officer Greg Carroll was one of the first here on the scene.
A real chaotic scene, but as you walked in, you could still smell the gun powder, the gun smoke still in the air.
Bystanders and victims still hiding behind pool tables. The place silent with fear. Veteran investigators who would later see this surveillance tape call it one of the most cold-blooded, vicious murders they've ever seen. Remember, the pool hall on the murder night was filled with about 50 people, including some small children, and left a lasting impression on Officer Carroll about Asian gangs.
I wouldn't say they're more violent, but they seem not to be as worried about the consequences of using violence.
Alleged killer Chu Yang is now in jail without bail. Fellow Wa Ching gang member Fuang Mac Lee, also known as Michael Lee, yesterday entered a guilty plea in exchange for 10 years in prison. He is the other pool hall shooter. Yang is scheduled to go to trial on murder charges later this month. But their case still disturbs Asian gang investigators for yet another reason. They believe this murder sparked a chain of at least 10 others senseless killings in the L.A. area by Asian Boys gang members. Asian gang investigator Deputy Bill Howell.
I thought that these types of groups would emerge about 5 years from now. And in reality, they emerged last year. So they are evolving faster than law enforcement can evolve to deal with them. And that's presenting a problem.
Meanwhile, four other watching gang members have already entered negotiated pleas of guilty in connection with the Lamech murder. The charges range from kidnapping and assault with a deadly weapon to accessories after the fact.
Well, that is really tough to watch. All right, Chris, thanks for your report.
You can check out his channel on YouTube at American Cholo. Ladies and gentlemen, Gil, how are you, man?
What's going on, man? Dusty, honor to be here with you, man. Talk to me.
So what made you start the American Cholo YouTube channel and brand?
Actually, it wasn't a thought of being a brand or a channel. What happened to me was about 2 years ago in January or February, right? I ended up getting my door kicked into my house. I ended up getting pulled over. Cops stole my phone. They did all kind of stuff. And then about 4 or 5 months before that, I was getting my phone tapped. So after that happened, it kind of jolted something in me, brother. They thought, because I still live in my neighborhood, because I still speak to a lot of my homies, because obviously I live maybe, I don't know, 4 blocks from my hood, homie.
Okay.
And they see me living, I got a nice home, nice cars, you know, I'm not talking about extravagant BMWs, nothing, no, I'm living the middle-class American dream life, let's say.
Yeah.
So these guys thought that I was running some type of either drug ring or having guys do robberies and stuff like that. And what these guys don't understand, the only thing I do with my homies is I try to get them work. I try to get them employment. So after they knocked my door down, did all this shit, it kind of just invited me so much that I was, you know what? You guys want to know who I am? You guys want to know what my story is? Here you go. And that's what prompted me to open up my YouTube channel.
One of the videos specifically that caught my attention was your video on YG song Go Loco and Blueface's song Carnesada.
Okay.
First of all, I think those songs are trash as hell, off top, personally.
Right.
But you dislike those songs for another reason. And explain to everyone why you made that particular video.
Yeah, I mean, first of all, when I made them, I always tell people that, listen, man, these are like my opinions, and this is a lot of Latinos' opinions. Just a lot of people don't know how to express themselves properly, and they end up fighting with each other verbally or whatnot.
Yeah.
Those songs, if you look at the song, and if you don't know any better, even young Latinos, I had one young guy call me that I know very well that has a show too, and told me, you know what, dude, I changed my mind after watching your video. Because young guys think that they're being paid homage to. First of all, let's take YG's song. YG's song, he's in there wearing a mariachi suit. That has nothing to do with the LA gang culture whatsoever. That's like me being a brown man. Imagine a Latino rapper wearing I'm sorry if I'm saying it wrong. Is it a shadiki?
A dashiki,
African attire. And instead of saying Maria, Maria, I'm talking about Shaniqua, Shaniqua.
Wait a minute. Oh, black people would be pissed.
Yeah, brother. So I'm like, wait a minute. And see, but they don't see that. And it's unfortunate, but sometimes, you know, it takes somebody to tell them, hey, guys, there's something wrong here. You guys, you know, you guys are not fucking being respectful to our culture. You guys wouldn't want this. The YG one, like I said on my video, I don't think YG did it so much disrespectfully. He obviously did it marketing reason. They want the Latino money is what it is, plain and simple. You know, because Latinos are the ones, they can say whatever they want. We're a driving force money-wise in just America, period, man. But we're not using Blueface song. No, that was just plain and simple disrespectful, brother. The guy, I remember I made that thumbnail and I had that Shaka Zulu. I photoshopped my face on Shaka Zulu. And I put, what if I did a song? I did a song, I forgot what I called it, the American Cholo Chronicles with that label on it, the album cover, you know, and I called it, you know, and I called some disrespectful shit. I showed it to my wife. She's like, man, you got to get out of this quarantine, man. You're bored. I said, no. You need to listen to the song.
Yeah.
I put it on for her. Her mouth opens like, what the hell is that? The song, as you can hear, the song starts with Orchata, Orchata, carne asada. I mean, there's nothing lyrical to it. There's nothing even remotely any kind of talent.
That's like saying chicken, watermelon.
Yeah, brother. Yeah. Imagine if we came out with that. Imagine if a white person, Eminem, came out with some shit like that.
Yeah.
No, you'll be gone. You'll be gone. You're going to be boycotted. You're going to be off the circuit. But the problem is that too many Latinos don't make noise because we've been so programmed to be like, dude, stop crying. Dude, don't do this. No. It's not crying, brother. It's us telling us, hey, dude, this is wrong. Because if not, the next song's going to be beaner, mojado, wetback. Why? Because we're not saying anything. We're not standing up for ourselves. And that's why I make those videos, brother. And if you saw at the beginning of the blue face when I did, what did I put out there? And I saw African-Americans most. Listen, the great part about my channel that I like, we have adult-like conversation. We don't sit here and disrespect each other and talk all kind of nonsense and just call each other racial names, because then you're not communicating with each other. So I did feel, though, in the comment section that some African-Americans got offended. And I was like, good, you're supposed to get offended by seeing blackface, because I put that blackface on there with the carne asada song. That's what he's portraying by doing stuff like that. That's what YG's portraying by doing it. They're doing blackface, but now they're doing brownface because they think they're paying homage to us, that they're showing love to the Raza. They're not showing love to the Raza. They're just trying to make money off us, brother. And I think that's wrong.